Hi everyone, welcome to Lead Squad's webinar today. As you know, the topic is how to drive traffic and leads with the Google Display Ads. Let me quickly take you guys through the agenda of the webinar, that is, what is it that you'll learn today from the session. You'll learn a little bit about what is the reach of the display network and what are the audience that you can reach out using the display network. You'll learn about the targeting options that are available in Google Display Ads. You'll learn what kind of marketing goals will display ads help you achieve. Then you'll learn how to set up a Google Display campaign. You'll learn how to measure the performance of a campaign, and you'll learn a little bit about remarketing. Now, I'll not go too much into the details of remarketing in this session because we have discussed that already in one of our previous sessions. So you can take a look at, if you want to go into the details of remarketing, that is how to create a remarketing campaign and all of that, you can just take a look at that recording, right? But I will take you guys briefly through what exactly it is that remarketing can help you achieve, right? So let me begin now the session by going over briefly about the Google Display Network. So why should you consider Google Display Network, right? It is definitely the world's largest online display network. It has more than 2 million sites under it, and its properties include popular sites like YouTube, Gmail and blog, right? So you don't want to miss out on the opportunity of targeting people who are visiting these popular websites. It serves 180 billion impressions each month, which is about 6 billion per day. So once again, there's your reason. Then Google Display campaigns reach 80%, it's about 90% of Google internet users. Then the consumers exposed to display ads are 155% more likely to search for brand specific terms. So you really don't want to miss out on the opportunity of targeting all of these people, given that these stats are pretty good, right? So that's why you should consider Google Display Network as well. Let me quickly take you guys through what exactly is there under Google Display Network. So there are three kinds of websites that generally come under this. The first is your Google AdSense publisher sites. Now these are the sites that a normal advertiser like would target. You can target this directly through your AdWords interface, right? So it has more than 204 million visitors every month. Then your second kind of sites are your double click ad exchange. Here there are hundreds of premium publishers under this. Now this is generally used by larger and mid-sized companies or advertising agencies. Now unlike AdWords, it does not provide an inventory of ad slots. The customers, which would be your advertisers, they must negotiate the pricing and placement themselves, right? So the third type of sites is your Google properties like YouTube, Blogger, Gmail, etc. Now on YouTube alone, there are more than 1 billion unique visits every month, right? So when a lot of traffic is on these sites, you would really be on the losing side when you are not targeting people when they are there, when they are consuming this kind of content, right? So once again, let me reiterate on the fact that you should complement your search ads with display ads, and now I'll give you the reason why. Research shows that people spend 5% of their time searching on search networks and 95% of their time reading content, sharing it and recommending it. Now that is where your display network comes into picture. Now, when the 5% of the times when they are searching for something using a keyword specific to what you are selling, what you have to offer, then you can target them using search your search ads. However, what about the 95% of the time when they are not really looking for anything, when they are just trying to consume content which is of interest to them? This is where your display ads would come into picture. This is where you can target them, right? So that's why it is very important that you use display ads as well along with your search ads. Of course, the results would depend on industry to industry, right? But you can of course try using the display ads and see how they work out for you when the opportunities that they have to offer is are so good, right? So another option, another thing that makes Google Display Ads a pretty good option is the targeting options that are available in display ads. Let me quickly take you guys through it to make it clearer why Google display campaigns can allow you to target people really specifically. Now there are two major targeting options that are there in Google Display Network. The first one is the contextual targeting and the second one is the audience targeting. Now by contextual targeting I mean that you will be able to target people based on where they are, on what websites they are, what is the kind of content that they are consuming, right? And you'll target them at the point of consumption, which would be the websites relevant to probably what you have to offer, right? Then the second type of targeting, which is the audience targeting, it would depend on who are these people. This would include everything from demographics to their past online behavior, right? So you'll be able to target people based on how they have behaved in the past. Now there are multiple targeting options that come under each of these categories. So let me take you guys through them. The first targeting option that comes under contextual targeting is your keyword targeting. So what is keyword targeting, right? This is how it works. You select some specific keywords which are relevant to what you have to offer, and Google would show your ads on web pages and websites that have those keywords, right? So for instance, if I want to run an ad for this particular webinar, for this particular session that we are having today, right? So I can put in keywords like Google AdWords, Google AdWords training, Google Ads. I can select and digital marketing if I want to go a little bit broader there, and then Google would show my ads on websites that have those keywords, right? Then the second type of targeting is your placement targeting. Here what you can do is you can type in the specific names of the websites, and Google would show your ads on those websites only. So taking the same example, if I want my ad for the webinar to show up on a site like Search Engine Journal or Mashable, etc., then I can just put the names of the website in, and Google would show my ads there, right? So that is how that would work. The third type of contextual targeting option is your topic targeting. Here, this is a pretty good option because there are a lot, many, over 1700 topics and subtopics that are there, that are specified by Google. And they have categorized the websites based on these topics. So if you don't specifically know what are the websites that you want to target, but you know that these are the kinds of websites, that I want to target, you can just choose those categories and Google will do the targeting for you, because it has already categorized the websites under different kinds of categories, different kinds of topics, right? So this can be a pretty good contextual targeting option for you. Then let's come to the second one, which is the audience targeting. Under the audience targeting, the first kind of targeting is a very basic demographics targeting. Here you can target people based on age, gender, location and language. Then comes your interest categories. Once again, like your topic category option, Google has Google gives you these options to choose from, right? It's there on the interface. Now how does this work? Now these interest categories are defined based on the past behavior of your audience, right? So the kind of websites that they visit, the kind of content that they've been consuming, based on that your interest categories are formed, right? So that is how you can target people based on how they have been what they have been doing online, right? Then the third option, which is remarketing. This can really help you get some good conversions, because this is how it works, right? Sometimes what happens is that audience, some people would come to your website maybe through search ads or through elsewhere, through direct traffic, whatever, and they'll not convert, right? They'll just bounce off. Now, what remarketing can help you achieve is that remarketing can help you get these people back to your website and maybe prompt them to take an action, right? So this traffic once again will be very, very relevant. Now the fourth kind of option, the fourth kind of audience targeting is your similar audience. Now you have your remarketing lists, right? What you can do is you can create similar lists that are similar to your remarketing lists. Google would do this by making a list for audience that has browsing data, browsing history similar to your remarketing lists. So this list would be similar to these lists. So once again, it will be very, very specific to what you have to offer. So these were the targeting options, and that is why Google Display Network can be a pretty good place to target audience very, very specifically. Right. So let's take a look briefly at what kind of advertising goals can Google Display Network help you achieve. Now, as a Google advertiser, what would be your aim, right? You would want to be found when people search for you using specific keywords. This would be through your search ads, right? And you also want to be in front of people who don't necessarily want to make the purchase right now, but they fit a particular persona. They fit the persona of your buyer profiles. Right, and you want to be in front of those people as well, because as I've said before, people spend 5% of their time searching and 95% of their time reading and consuming different kind of content. Right, so you want to catch hold of those people 95% of the times as well. Right, so okay, this is how it works. Now, somebody searches for a keyword which is relevant to what you have to offer on Google. People, they would see this, your search network ads that you're already running. They'll click on the ad, they'll come to your website or your landing page. And there can be two scenarios now. Either they'll fill your form there and the lead details will be captured, or they'll just bounce off without taking any action. Now, these are the guys that you can target using your display campaigns and you can make use of the remarketing thing here, right? So these guys who bounce off, you can retarget them through remarketing, and when they are consuming some content which is similar to what you have to offer, then these ads would appear on the display network, right? And then if the person is interested at that point, then they may click the ad, come back to the website and complete the section. Then once again, the lead details will be captured, right? So this is how you can use a display campaign to complement your keyword, your search campaigns, right? But what about the second time, the second scenario, when the person is not searching, but when they might fit the persona of your buyer profile, like they might have a persona similar to your buyer profile. So that is where your normal display campaigns will come into picture, right? Because you are defining different kinds of targeting options, like you might be using keywords, or you might be using topic targeting or interest targeting to target these people. So then you will be able to catch hold of people who might not be searching at that point of time, but who might be interested in what you have to offer. So this search, this combination of search plus display can really help you if you capture lead details efficiently, right? So this is your advertising goal that your display campaigns can help you achieve. Now, let's come to the steps of creating a display campaign. I'll take you guys through the process online. I'll do that. Before that, let me take you guys through a few prerequisites of the campaign. right? So here are the prerequisites. The first thing that you would require before you actually get into the details of before you get into creating the campaign is the image, right? So there are two options here. If you don't have somebody who will do the images for you, and if you have to do it yourself, then there is an interface which is available in Google that allows you to create simple images using some predefined templates that are there, right? You can make use of that. However, if you have somebody creative to create these ad images for you, then I think that you should go with that option, because then you can create images which are really, really relevant to what you have to offer. Then you can match the color schemes and everything with your landing page as well. So this will be a good option to do. So these are the dimensions that Google AdWords allows. Google AdWords has for running these display campaigns. So there is this leaderboard, which the dimensions of which are 728 into 90 pixels, right? Then there's your square banner, which is 250 into 250px. Then there's your medium rectangle, which is 300 into 250px. Then there's your large rectangle, which is 336 into 280px. Now this is the kind of ad that we have seen gets the best CTR, at least for our campaigns. The results may vary, but this is the one that gets the that gets the best CTR. Then there is your banner, which is 468 into 60px. Your skyscraper, which is 120 into 600px, and your wide skyscraper, which is 160 into 600px. Right, and then they're interchanged here. Right. So the second prerequisite would be your landing page, right? Because what action would you want to take? Would you want your audience to take once they click on the ad and come to your landing page, right? Come to your website, instead of redirecting people to your website where they would not know which action to take. You can redirect them to a lead capture page instead, where you can actually capture their details. Now one thing that you have to do is make sure that there is a message match between the creative and the landing page, otherwise your conversion rates would drop, right? It's a pretty obvious thing to say, right? So this is your second prerequisite, your landing page or your lead capture page. Now the third prerequisite, your conversion script. Now your conversion script is the one that will help you that will help you actually count the conversions that happen through your ads, right? The conversions that happen. Now I'll not go into the complete details of creating it, but here I've listed the steps, so you can get it from Google AdWords, right? You have to go to AdWords, you'll see tools and analysis option, then go to conversions, new conversion, customize settings, and save. It'll give you a script. This is the script, a kind of script that it'll give you. All that you have to do is you have to copy this and paste it on your post submission landing page, which is the page that comes after the visitor has taken an action on your landing page. That is after the visitor fills the form, he might get a page which can be a thank you page or your website, and then the conversion is counted, right? So you're supposed to put it on the post submission page. Right. So once again, now that in addition to this, that will be your another prerequisite, which is a thank you page, because you need to create the post submission page and embed this script there, right? So to do that, you need to have that page created as well, right? So that can be your fourth prerequisite. Now I'll go into the details of how to create your display campaign, a basic display campaign. So this is the aim of my test campaign. We are conducting a webinar on Google AdWords in the US on 24th January. So what I'll do is I'll create a campaign for that. Now the landing page, I have already created a landing page. This is the landing page. I'll just have it open, right? So that I can just simply copy its URL there. Then I need to have a thank you page with conversion pixel setup, right? Conversion tracking setup. So this is my thank you page, which is once again ready. And this is my image, which is ready, right? This is the image that I'm gonna use. So let me, let me show you how your conversion script, when it's embedded, it will look. Just go to the view source and check the conversion. See, here's my Google conversion script embedded on the thank you page, right? Somebody fills out this form, they reach this particular page, and then the conversion is counted. This is how it's gonna work. Now, let me quickly go into the AdWords interface. Right. So what I'll do is I'll create a new campaign. Right. This will be my test campaign. I'll select the option display network only. Let me call it Google AdWords US Webinar Test. Once again, the option here is display network only. It has to be all features campaign, right? Now, let me take a look at the advanced. These options are fine for now. So, because the webinar is supposed to be in US, I will choose the locations as United States and Canada, right? Okay. So language, I don't want to choose these different languages. I am comfortable with the English here. So that is what I'm gonna choose. Then your bidding and budget options. Let's see. What I want to do is you can do is you can, for now, you can create a CPC campaign, but later on when you have some data here, you can create your conversion optimizer option, right? So I'll just choose this particular option right now. And the budget, let me just set it as $1,000 per day, right? So delivery method, this is fine. Add extensions, I'm not gonna choose any ad extensions for now. You can schedule your campaign as well. So as my webinar is supposed to be on 24th, I can set the end date for it to be maybe say 24th itself, right? So then I won't have to come back and pause my campaign. It will get paused on its own, right? The ads will stop showing after this. This is fine. Now I'll optimize for conversions here. Like this is actually what I was talking about initially. Right. Social settings are fine. So I'll just save and continue now. Right. Now let me call this ad group test ad group. Now these are the different targeting options that I had spoken about earlier. So let me show you all of them one by one. So display keywords. What are the kind of keywords that I can choose? As once again, this webinar is for Google AdWords. So let me call it Google AdWords as a keyword. What I'll do is I'll try to find more related keywords here. So I can add Google AdWords. Right. Just marketing keywords. Yeah, training. Right. So I've selected only five keywords here, but you can select multiple. Right. So that you have all of your, you can maybe I can go for a broader targeting like digital marketing also, because these digital marketing web pages with the keywords digital marketing etc will also be relevant to my target audience, right? Yeah, so see, I've selected my 8 keywords here. Now I can narrow my targeting further by choosing one of the other targeting options, I mean, all of one or all of the other targeting options, but generally you should not choose all of the different targeting options together, because otherwise your campaigns would be your targeting would be too narrowed down, and you might not be able to reach too many people, right? So okay, I'll select another targeting option, which is interest category. See, I can go for remarketing lists as well here, if you have remarketing lists created. So I'll just show you the interest categories that are there, the interest categories that I had spoken about. Now these categories are they would depend on the browsing history of the different people. So let me see if any of these categories fits my criteria, right? Right, see, I can add this advertising and marketing option, right? Correct. Now you can see that the number of impressions change depending on whatever targeting options that I'm choosing. Once again, I can narrow my targeting down further by using other options. See, I can choose topics as well. Topics, as I had told you, that Google has clubbed different websites based on the kind of content that the websites have into different categories. So you can make that choice as well here. So let me once again see what is there under business and industrial. Marketing, right, telemarketing. So okay, all right, okay, let me take a look at this. Okay, so this this can be relevant to me, so I can select this option. See, as you can see, the impressions, the number of impressions that I will receive gets narrowed down further when I do that. Once again, I can select other options also. I'll show you how to use the placement options. Now, as I had taken the example of Search Engine Journal before, so Search Engine Journal can be a really relevant website for the kind of people that I'm trying to target. So let me just look for that. Right, then I can try to target people who are on Mashable as well. Right, Mashable is here. So right, see, the impressions got narrowed down further. Once again, I can choose the age options as well. See, these people are not really relevant to me, right? See, the number reduced once again, right? The gender would not really be, I wouldn't want to be specific about the gender here, so I'll not choose that option. Now see, I did this to show you all of the different targeting options that are available, but these impressions are just not enough. I'll not get enough impressions if I choose targetings that are this broad. So what I'll do is I'll remove these other targeting options, right, for now, to create this ad. Right, I'll I'll take do the placement thing again. So these are the two options that are there. Right, I already have these placements selected. So okay, let me save and continue this. Now I've come to the option where I can create my ads. Now as I've told you before, if you don't have a creative guy at your place who can do the images for you, then you can use Google's display ad builder, which allows you multiple templates to choose from, right? And all that you have to do is change the messages, change the CTA, etc., and you'll have a simple image, ad image ready for your ad, right? But if you want to be really, really specific, and if you have somebody who can help you create the images, you should go with the image ad option. That is what I am gonna go with because I already have an image, right? So okay, this is my image that is there. I'll choose only one option, which is 336 into 280 for the purpose of this, but you should choose to show all of the different dimensions that are there and then analyze which one is working the best for you. This one right now works the best for us, right? So I'll just call it test ad. Display URL has to be once again similar to what is the whole concept of your campaign. It should be somewhat similar to that. Right? So destination URL will be your landing page URL that is there. So this is what I'm going to do. I'll just paste it here, right? I don't really want to show my ad on mobile, so I'll not make this selection. So yes, I'm done. I can just save the ad, and after your standard verification process of Google, my ad will start showing up depending on the targeting options that I've chosen, right? So this is how you can create a simple ad campaign on Google Display Network, right? So yeah, that was pretty basic, right? Wasn't it? So okay, this was one method that I discussed. Now, as I've shown you before, you can use Display Ad Builder also to create the ad, as well as you can use the Display Planner also to create the ad, right? So Display Planner is more or less like Keyword Planner. It will allow you to select the different kinds of targeting options, etc. there itself. You can check it out. It's pretty simple. It's pretty simple to use. So alright, that was how you could create an ad. Let's go to how to measure the performance of the ad. So there are a few metrics that you look at. You look at the click-through rate. You've seen that 0.2% to 0.6% of click-through rate you've seen. So it'll once again, it'll depend on your industry to industry, right? Then you should look at the conversion percentage. Conversion percentage, that is the number of people who are actually converting on your website, on your landing page, right? Then you would look at cost per lead as well. This cost per lead should make sense, because then once again you have to analyze the lead quality as well. If the lead quality is very bad and cost per lead is pretty high, then there's no use running these ads anymore, right? Then you should probably stick to your search ads, or probably you should use remarketing campaigns if you want to use the display ones, your display ads. And then that's what you can use very specific targeting options if that is the kind of problems that you're facing, right? So these are the kind of metrics that you should look at to measure the performance of your ad, and then make a call on whether you want to continue with the display ads or not. Now let's discuss a little bit about remarketing and why you should do it. So as I've emphasized on this before, that it's important because remarketing would help you get the people who leave your website without completing an action. It'll help you bring them back to your website. But why do you need to do that? See, it's been recorded that 96% of people visit a website and they leave without completing the action that the marketers want them to take. 96% is a very big number. So you will want to bring these people back to your website. So that's why you should be doing remarketing. Then in terms of e-commerce, 70% of shoppers abandon their shopping carts rather than completing their purchase. So once again, you would want to target these people and bring them back to your website, because maybe at that point of time they were doing something else, they got distracted and bounced off and moved away from your website. But there's a good probability that they'll take that action that you want them to take on a later date, at a later time, right? So that's why you should be remarketing, right? I'll take an example. It is from Google's case studies itself. How remarketing helped Western Governors University double conversions and lower costs, right? So I'll just give you briefly what the goals were, what was the approach taken, and what were the results that they received. Their goal was to enroll more students in the university. They wanted to identify low cost and high return marketing opportunities, and they wanted to re-engage visitors after they leave the website. The approach that was taken was they added remarketing to existing features using the Google Display Network. They tailored ads to different audiences, right? And they began with image ads and later added text and video ads as well. The results that they received was that compared to search campaign, the conversion rate was nearly double. Now that is that can really, really help, because that will bring the cost of the lead down by half, won't it, right? So that's why this is, of course, this is one case, but if remarketing, if done properly, it can actually help other businesses also achieve results which are as good or better than before, at least. So that's why you should be remarketing as well. Now I've come to the end of the webinar as such, but there were a few problems. Actually, we conducted a survey before the webinar, and we sent the survey to all of the attendees, and of the attendees that actually finished the survey, there were a few problems, a few specific issues that they wanted us to cover. So I'll just briefly see if I can answer the queries that people had from that survey. So the first question was, thing was that the leads are lower quality as compared to search network. Yes, that would happen, because unlike search, these people are not specifically looking for what you have to offer, right? So it's very much possible that the quality of the leads will be lower than your normal search ad quality, right? What you can do is, to avoid this, you can use specific placement options, or you can use specific topic options. If you have really, really narrow targeting, then your the quality of the lead would it's likely that it would improve, right? So another problem that was there was someone ran the display network for contextual ads, which I'm supposing is the keyword one, and faced the main problem of relevant targeted pages to show the ads. He applied the filter, but it made campaigns very thin, right? So of course, if you want to run ads that are very, very specific, then the campaign targeting options would be thin. You would not be able to target too many people. But the benefit, the upside of this is that the traffic that you'll be getting will be high quality, right? Compared to if you do not apply too many targeting options, and you have very very generic campaign, then the lead quality will be low, right? Even though the lead volume will be high, but the quality will be lower. So you have to compromise on either the quality or the number of people that number of the traffic that actually comes on your website. Now, if you want to make your campaigns not very thin, what you can do is, you as I told you before, that don't use all of the different targeting options at once, right? Use a couple of them and see how that works out, right? So that is what you can do. Then okay, somebody had this problem of setting up, they wanted to know how to set up a remarketing campaign. So as I told in the beginning of the webinar, I'll not go into the details of the remarketing because we've already covered that in one of the previous webinars. So I'll show you where you can access the recording for that particular webinar. Right, so you go to the Lead Squad website, you go to the resources section, you'll see multiple things here like marketing ebooks, past webinars, right? WordPress plugins by Lead Squad, Lead Squad demo. Go to the past webinar option. Here you'll see multiple webinars that were conducted before. You can access the remarketing one here itself, right? So yeah, you can access it from there. Another problem was that in Display Network they not seeing any relevant placements to drive relevant traffic to my website. So instead of the placement option, what you can do is you can use the topic option, because as I've said before that using the topic options, Google has tried to club similar kind of websites together, right? So you'll be able to target relevant traffic and you'll be able to target some people, like, using that option, right? So use that. So all right, the next thing that was there was somebody wanted to know how to effectively use newsletters and blogs as a lead capture tool. Once again, we have covered this in one of the previous webinars, so you can access the recording once again from where I showed you the resources section, right? Then someone said that they want to create better ads beyond the templates that Google provides. So the only thing that I can tell you here is you can take the help of a creative guy, somebody who can create these images for you, right? Then only you'll be able to get that kind of quality, the kind of quality that you want, right? Then somebody wanted to know about Google Analytics remarketing. So this is a topic that can be that is pretty broad, so pretty wide, so we can cover another webinar and we can cover this particular topic on that. So I'll not go into the details of that in this particular session. Then how to increase website conversion rates. So for that, if you are redirecting the multiple things, the very first very basic one, if you are redirecting traffic to your website, use landing pages instead. Use landing pages for lead capture. Use landing pages that have that are very very specific, very very relevant to the kind of ad that you have created. The objective of your landing page, the landing page and image, the ad image should not be different. It should be very similar to each other, so that people who come after clicking the ad, they complete the action on the website, right? So this is how you can increase the website conversion rates. Yeah, so okay, that's it. That was all for the webinar today. Thank you for attending.